Start house. This is Paul Hildgartner at the end of the third round, the leader of the men's singles competition in Luge here. He is now waiting for his moment to go down the run, a moment obviously of incredible tension. Jeff, earlier you asked him what it would take to win here.
It's difficult to drive four runs. I hope I can drive all four runs, and so we look what place we have.
So you think consistency, day after day, being fast four times is going to be the toughest thing, and you have to do that day in and day out, four fast ones.
Yes, I think drive four runs, it's very difficult, and for me, I hope to drive all four runs, and it's the big problem here in this track.
This is Paul Hildgartner now. Jeff, a major development. They chose to sweep the track just now, as they did before Valerie Dudan's run. So this is good news for Paul Hildgartner. Very good news.
Very good news, and it just might be this gold medal is his destiny. We saw the difference it made for Dudan to have the clean sweep. He moved into first place. Hildegardner's got the fastest track possible today, and I think he'll be able to do it.
Okay, you better believe that the people from Hildgartner's small hometown of Kainz in the Sud Tyrol region of Northern Italy will be following this every heartbeat of the way. Incredible excitement here. A man who's devoted his life to the sport of luge, now with the dream within possibility, has made Jeff what seemed to me to be a bad start.
It wasn't very strong. It looks like he caught the right wall, but Paul can make that up. He's so fast on the bottom part of the track. I think he'll come through without any problem, but let's hang on.
All right, the time he needs to beat is Valerie Dudan's time. We'll see the split coming up in a couple of seconds. There's what he needs to beat, and no, he's a little slow. This is bad, but he does have a cushion because of the fast times coming into this.
He's got to hang on. He looks very smooth right now. He had a half-second lead going into this thing. Hang on, Paul. That's all I can say. Hang on. The gold medal's yours.
I know you're rooting for him, Jeff. He's married. He has a son. He probably will retire after this race.
He's got it. He's got it, Jim. He's got it.
All right. He's flying. He made it up to that bad start. He's taken the lead. Paul Hildgartner. This could be the dream of a lifetime fulfilled. Paul Hildgartner. Jeff, I know you were pulling for him. He seems delighted.
Fastest run of the day, Sam. He rose to the occasion. What an effort. The gold medal for Paul Hildegardner for sure, and he's got to be happy. There he goes, up on the shoulders.
That's just terrific. There is still one run by Sergei Danilin to come.
Danilin's not going to be able to catch him, Sam. He had a half second. Paul with the fastest run of the day right there. Danilin would have to do something I think is impossible today. Paul Hildegardner, gold medalist. What a great moment for him.
31 years old, an entire life devoted to losing. He first lost when he was 8 or 9 years old outside of his own house on his way to school. He has, for the last decade or so, exemplified what it is to be great at this sport. He is much loved by his fellow losers and, of course, respected by all of his opponents. Sergei Danilin, moments away now from his start. As we said, the only person left seriously in medal contention. 24 years old, lives in Moscow. He's an only child whose success in this sport has brought him elevated status at the in the Soviet Union.
Danilin obviously knows that the gold medal is out of reach right now. He looks a little bit disappointed, Sam, but he almost looks sorrow-stricken.
You know, it must be psychologically, when you know that your chance of the gold has suddenly, well, not evaporated, we can't say that, but has become almost an impossible one, it must take the wind out of your sails.
I think Danilin came to this race fully expecting to win the gold medal. He's been able to beat everybody on every other track. He never got it together in this race, though. Hildegardner's been ahead of him almost every single training run and almost every single race run. You can see the heads all the way back. He's just letting it fly, all or nothing.
All right, well, of course, he finished second to Hildegardner in the pre-Olympic trials here, Jeff. So one way or another, you got to say that under this magnificent loose track here at Mount Shemetic, it is Paul Hildegardner who has the measure of this man, Sergei Danilin. Watch the split time. It's an excellent split time, though, Jeff. This is incredible. Perhaps not for the gold medal, but certainly for the silver. He's racing his teammate, Valerie Dudan, also.
Oh, he's already cracked.
Boy, he's back on. I thought he was out of it. Incredible. unexpected, everything that happened on that run.
Danilin almost moved into last place on that run. That sled was sideways, Sam. He was all but over. He brought it back. He's got to be relieved. The silver medal, the strong effort to get that sled back over, but still, he wanted the gold.
The power and the reflexes, Jim, to correct for what was imminent disaster. He's happy. He knows realistically he knew a few minutes ago after Hildgartner's run he probably couldn't take the gold, but he still had a shot at the silver, and he came through. What a sport of split-second development.
So, the standings after the final run in men's luge. The winner, Paul Hildgartner of Italy. This is the first gold medal won in these Olympics by an Italian. In second and third, two Soviets, Sergei Danilin, who fought back from a poor first run, and 20-year-old Valerie Duden. Frank Maisley, who was given that controversial rerun earlier in the day, has finished 14th. Here's Jeff with Paul Hildgartner.
Paul, you happy? Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Tell us, I'm happy? Happy?
Yes, very happy, yes.
Okay, 1988 in Calgary?
Maybe not for competed, maybe for watch, I don't know.
Anyway, congratulations, we're all
very,
very proud
much.
Of you.
Thank
the
you
Americans
very
are very happy. Thank you very
much.
So that's it for now from Mount Trebevich, where a man has had his dream come true today, and where the members of the American team have shown considerable toughness and promise in a sport still so little known in our country. This is Sam Posey for Jeff Tucker and myself. So long and good sledding.